In this video, we're going to start the Kuta Software Infinite Geometry Free Worksheet Translations. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this worksheet. Our directions in this video are to graph the image of the figure using the transformation given. Now, for a translation, we're not flipping or rotating the figure at all, we're simply moving it. So in number one, it instructs us that we have a translation that's 5 units right and 1 unit up. So starting with point T, we're going to move that point 5 units to the right. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we're going to move it 1 unit up. And then 1 up. So our new point, T, will land on the x-axis. And the way we label T, T prime, which is T with the apostrophe symbol, T prime. Now, we're going to translate G. We're going to move it 5 units to the right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 1 unit up. So here will be G prime. And lastly, our last point is B. So moving it 5 units to the right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 1 unit up, B prime. And now that we have all our points, we're also going to translate the lines. So G was connected to B, so G prime will be connected to B prime. G was connected to T, so G prime will be connected to T prime. And T prime will be connected to B prime since point T was connected to point B. And that's our translated figure and number one. And I recommend using a straight edge when dealing with lines to get a crisp, clean line. Now let's move on to number two. In number two, our translation is 1 unit to the left and 2 units up. Starting with point Y, we're going to go 1 unit to the left in the X direction and 2 units up in the Y direction. That's where we'll have Y prime. Next, let's look at point G. 1 unit to the left and 2 units up in the positive Y direction. That's where we will have G prime. And then lastly, point M. 1 unit to the left and 2 units up. That will give us M prime. Now we'll connect. M was connected to G, so M prime is connected to G prime. M was connected to Y, so M prime and Y prime are connected through a straight line. And Y was connected to G, so Y prime will be connected to G prime. And that's our new triangle in number two. In number three, we're simply moving 3 units down. So 3 units in the negative Y direction. So moving U down 3 units, 1, 2, 3. This is U prime. Moving Q down 3, 1, 2, 3 will give us Q prime. And moving L down 3 will give us L prime. And then we'll connect those points back together. U prime to Q prime, U prime to L prime, and Q prime to L prime. Moving on to number four, we're moving 5 units to the right and 2 units up. So that's 5 units in the positive X direction and 2 units in the positive Y direction. Starting with X, 5 units to the right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 2 units up, 1, 2. That is going to be X prime. Now let's go on to E. We're going 5 units to the right and 2 units up. That is where we'll have E prime. And lastly, for I, 5 units to the right and 2 units up will be I prime. Now connecting each of those. X prime to I prime, X prime to E prime, and then I prime to E prime. That is our new triangle in number four. And number five, we're going 4 units to the right and 4 units down. So I'm going to show you another method that you can use. Assuming that this point is 0, 0, and our number line counts by 1. So it's negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4. Let's label each of our coordinates. So I is negative 1, 2. J is negative 5, 5. And A is negative 5, 1. So writing those, I, J, and A, negative 1, 2, negative 5, 5, and then negative 5, 1. If we're going 4 units to the right and 4 units down, that's a positive 4 in the x direction and a negative 4 in the y direction. So we're going to add 4 to our x coordinates and subtract 4 from our y coordinates. So I prime, we're going to take negative 1 and add 4, going 4 to the right, and we're going to take 2 and subtract 4. So I prime is equal to negative 1 plus 4, which is a positive 3, and then 2 minus 4 is a negative 2. Now going to J prime, we're going to have negative 5 plus 4, since we're moving to the right 4 in the positive x direction, and 5 minus 4, since we're moving down 4 in the y direction. So J prime will be negative 5 plus 4, which is negative 1, and 5 minus 4, which is 1. And lastly, we'll have A prime. That's going to be negative 5 plus 4 and 1 minus 4. Negative 5 plus 4 is negative 1, and 1 minus 4 is negative 3. So let's graph I prime, J prime, and A prime. So 3, negative 2 will be I prime. J prime, negative 1, 1, negative 1, positive 1. So that's J prime. And A prime, negative 1, negative 3. Now I'll connect J prime to A prime to I prime, and J prime to I prime. So that's just one more method for performing a translation. Now let's move on to number 6, the last problem that we'll do in this video. In number 6, we have another translation. This translation is 2 units to the right, so that's 2 units in the positive x direction, and 3 units up, so 3 units in the positive y direction. Starting with J, we're going to go 2 units to the right, and then we're going to go 3 units up. That will be J prime. Notice that point E is 1 unit down from J. So E prime, since all we're doing is moving it, E prime will be the same relation to J prime. So E prime is just going to be 1 unit down from J prime. And if you want to double check, move it 2 units to the right, and then 3 units up. Next, we'll move on to M, 2 units to the right and 3 units up. That will be M prime. And in relation to M, X is 1 unit down and 2 units to the right. So for X prime, 1 unit down and 2 units to the right of M prime is X prime. And if we want to double check that position, 2 units to the right and 3 units up is our translation. Now I'll connect the points that need to be connected. J prime to M prime, J prime to E prime to X prime, and then M prime to X prime. Join me in the next video where I'll finish this worksheet completing numbers 7 through 12. And as always, like, subscribe, and share.